Calling this place remote would be an understatement. Thousands of acres of Alaskan wilderness on an uninhabited island. But you, the American taxpayer, are kicking in almost $60 million to build an airport here. That's right, your money for an airport on a deserted island.
The airport is slated to be done August of 2012.
Joe Bariskin is the mayor of Akutan, Alaska, which is on another island 6 miles away. The airport is being built for his town, which has 100 residents. So you might wonder, as we did, why the 100 citizens of mountainous Akutan need an airport that's pricing out at about $77 million, most of it paid by you.
We have over 1,000 people that we need to serve.
Indeed, in addition to his 100 residents, there are about 1,100 other people who either come by boat or by occasional seaplane to work in Akutan, at the largest seafood processing plant in the U.S., called the Trident Seafood Company. Everyone agrees Trident will be the primary user of the airport, and the company's getting a pretty good deal for it. Of the $77 million the airport is expected to cost, Trident will pay $1 million. Steve Ellis is with Taxpayers for Common Sense.
We're looking at a waste of money here, and this is something where that you have a private company that is standing to get a driveway built for them by the taxpayer. And so this is outrageous use of taxpayer funds.
Trident's plant manager is Dave Abassian.
The driveway for Trident, this airport. What's your response to that?
To a naked eye, you can't argue that.
But Trident says it has built its own infrastructure on this island, improved the lives of the native population, and sees no reason it should pay more than $1 million.
This is not something that is being handed to us. It is something that we've earned through all the contributions that we made towards the tax dollars. We have paid millions and millions in tax dollars.
Many of the families who've been here for generations agree, saying the plant has improved opportunities. In the small post office, a postal worker says he doesn't feel badly about U.S. taxpayers footing most of the bill.
We all pay taxes just like everybody else does.
Trident changed the lifestyle in Akutan.
And as we continued talking to the mayor, the conversation struck a nerve.
If Trident wasn't here, do you think you would need this airport for 100 people?
No, that doesn't make sense, no.
So you would acknowledge that Trident needs it far more than your people need it?
The city of Akutan as a community, we are a community, Gary. You need to open your eyes and see Akutan as a community. You need to turn the camera off. If you keep insisting on that, I'm talking to you, Gary.
But it's not only the airport funding that's getting negative attention.
It's still not clear how the passengers will get there. The original plan was a hovercraft at the cost of $13 million. But in other parts of Alaska, it doesn't always work. Then there's the thought of a helicopter. That's also very expensive. Or a boat like this one, but it takes between 20 and 40 minutes to get there, and it's cold and uncomfortable. So even though the airport's about to open, we don't know how people will get there.
It took us more than 2 days just to get there for our story.
Much of the time here, perhaps more than half the time, the waves are too high, the wind's too severe to get a boat close to the island where the airport is. Today is one of those days.
So we waited for the next day. The winds diminished, the skies cleared. We took a cargo boat, then a skiff. But there was a 90-foot muddy cliff between us and the construction site. We had to scale it so we could see how much progress was being made. Even the Trident bosses haven't yet been to the site.
Made it.
About 25 construction workers are living on the island for up to 2 months at a time. Gravel is just starting to be laid down on the runway. The airport project is on schedule. This is your airport, American taxpayer, even though seeing it on TV is probably the closest you'll ever get to it. Gary Tuckman, CNN, Akutan, Alaska.